Hello everyone. Now in this video, we'll talk about Windows security, that how we can secure our Windows operating system. So first of all, we will talk about that how we can secure our SAM file. So I told you earlier that SAM file consists our Windows password. Now the main thing is that we have to secure our SAM file in order to protect our Windows authentication. So there is one small utility in Windows called as Syskey. So Syskey stands for system key, and with the help of this utility, we can encrypt the passwords which are present inside the SAM file. And Syskey supports 128-bit RC4 encryption, and by using Syskey, what we can do is we can also add one more boot time password in order to protect our Windows operating system. So by adding boot time password, what happens is, so once we start our system, so first of all we have to enter our user passwords, then we have to enter Syskey password, then we are able to log in. So this is the beauty of Syskey, and I recommend you to please do use Syskey in your system. Now let's talk about that how we can secure computers if your computer is a part of a domain. So there is one policies called as group edit policies. So if you are a network administrator and you want to secure your domain by changing its security policies, then you can change by going here to gpedit.msc in run bar. So this will open a group edit policy for editor for you. So you can then change the security policy of that domain by using groupeditpolicy.msc. But what if your computer is not a part of a domain? So if your computer is not a part of a domain, then what we can do, we can change your security policies of your local system by going here, that is securitypolicies.msc. So you can open gpedit policies, sec policies in run bar. So these are a few measures which we can do in order to secure our Windows operating system. Now let's talk about one of the best product of Microsoft which we can use in order to scan our system for the various security issues. So the name of that product is Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. So Microsoft Security Baseline Analyzer is one of the best security product of Microsoft. So by using this product, what we can do, we can scan our system for system vulnerabilities, for missing security updates, and in the last, this product will make a final report for us. And what is the main feature of this product? That we can scan our own computer. Otherwise, we can scan multiple computers in our domain. So I recommend you to please download and install this tool. So you can download the tool from here. And once you download and install this tool, please run your tool in your computer in order to scan security issues in your system. So now let's see that how we can use all these techniques in order to secure our Windows system. Now let's secure our Windows operating system. So first of all, we will see that how we can encrypt the passwords which are present inside the SAM database. Well, there is one small utility in Windows called as Syskey. So just open your run bar and just write down here Syskey and click on OK. So Syskey stands for SAM lock tool, and with the help of this utility, we can encrypt the passwords which are present inside the SAM database. And by default, there is only one option enabled, can you see here, encryption enabled. And if we click on OK, then the passwords which are present in the form of hashes in SAM database will just get encrypted. And it's irreversible option, means once we encrypt the SAM database, we won't be able to decrypt that. So if I just click on OK, so you can see here that our passwords are encrypted. Now let's just go back here and open that utility again. So there is one more security feature in this utility. So here you can see one button called as update. So if I just click over here, then if I just click over here in password startup, then it asks us for adding the additional password. So if you want to set one more password in your Windows, then you can, by just writing over here password and confirm password, by doing it, so when your system will boot up, the first of all you have to add the account password, then you have to add a Syskey password, then you will get prompted to your home screen. So by doing it, so it also add one more security measures. So let me just click on OK. So this is the first security implementation. Then what else we can do is, if your computer is a part of a domain, then we can add its group edit policies, then even we can change and configure its computer's security policies. So currently right now, my computer is not a part of a domain. So what we can do is, so I can configure its security policies depending upon my need. So what else you can do if you are a system administrator? So what you can do is, you can configure security policies of all the computers which are present in your domain by going here to gpedit.msc. So this will open a group edit policy editor for you. So you can see here it's a local group policy editor. So this will only work if your system is connected to a particular domain.
So you can see here there are a lot of policies, software settings, window settings, administrative templates, and so more. So if you only want to change a policies or if you want to edit security policies in your local computer, then what you have to open your run bar and just write down here secpol.msc. Just hit enter and it will open a local security policy editor for you, and this security policies is only for your computer. So you can see here that right now we are inside this local security policy editor, and on the left hand side there are different account policies. You can see here there are different security settings. So what we will do is now we will one by one go through these security policies. So first of all, there are policies related to the account. And if I just expand this account policies, then the category is divided into two types. The first one is policies related to the password, then the policies related to the account. So if I click over here to password policies, and in the right hand side you will see a policy name and its security settings. So here is one policy, you can see here maximum password age. So my maximum password age is 41. So what we can do is, so you can configure this maximum password age, means after a particular time your password will be expired, then your system will ask for changing your password and adding a new password. So you can also configure the minimum password age, then you can also configure the minimum password length. So if you just write here 10 and click on apply and OK, then if a user wants to change its password, then he or she have to fulfill this criteria, means its password minimum password length should be more than 10 characters. And here you can see that the password must meet the complexity requirement, so you also have to enable it. So once you enable this thing, then the user have to follow these all criteria in order to change its password. So what else you can do? You can also store passwords using reversible encryption. So this was all about password policies. Now let's talk about account lockout policies. So account lockout policies are policies that are related to the account. So just for example, if a user is doing invalid attempts, login invalid attempts, so what you want to do? So here is one policy you can see here, account lockout threshold, which means if user is doing invalid login attempt, then you can block that particular account. So you can just mention it over here that after how many invalid login you want to block the account, then here is account lockout duration, that for how much time you want to lock account, like you want to lock for a particular days, for a minutes, and so on. Then reset account lockout count after, means it's not applicable right now because we haven't set it this policy, but we can do this thing by going over here account lockout policies. Then right after account lockout policies, there are some local policies. And in the local policies, you can see here audit policies, user right assignment, and security options. So these policies are actually used for assigning a particular thing to a user. So you can see here that access credential manager as a trusted caller, then access this computer from the network policy, then bypass traverse checking, change the system time, you want to change the system time, then you want to change the time zone, then you can by going over here, and even take ownership of files and other object. So you can also change it from here. Then the next thing we can do is, even if you want to change some security options for a particular user, so you can see here that accounts administrator account status is disabled. We don't want to make this operating system or this account as an administrator, so you can just going, you can do so by going here. Then you want to block a particular Microsoft account, then you want to rename administrator account, and even you want to restrict a particular user to access a CD-ROM or even a USB drive, then you can by going over here. Even you can add a domain controller, LDAP server signing requirements. So what you can do is, if you're system administrator and if you want that a user will not be able to access a USB port, then you can just disable the USB port by going over here to the local security policy editor and inside the security options. So there are tons of security policies you can see here. Some of related to the network, some of them are related to applications, some of them are related to user accounts. So you can see here the policies related to the cryptography is also present, and so on. Then right after local policies, there are some policies which are related to Windows Firewall. So the policies which are related to Windows Firewall is actually divided into three categories: inbound rules, outbound rules, means inbound policies, outbound policies, and connection security policies. So if a particular application which is on the internet want to make a connection with your computer, then you can define a particular policies in here to the inbound rules by clicking over here to the new rules. So you can allow a particular program to connect with your computer through a particular port or through particular using a particular protocol. And even you can define a custom rule. And in the outbound rules, if your computer wants to connect with outside a server, or if your computer wants to connect to the internet, then you can specify here a new rule that through which port your computer can connect and what kind of security measures your computer will follow. Then here connection security rules will defines that once your computers are connected, both computers are connected, what kind of security rules you want to implement. So this was all about in Windows Firewall and advanced security policies. Then there are some policies related to public key policies that related to the certificates, your system certificate, SSL certificate. Then if your computer is using a BitLocker protection, then all the policies related to here are here. But now this time I haven't enabled this BitLocker in my system. So the data protection policies, encryption file system, so on and so forth. And now let's talk about software restriction policies. So software restriction policies are actually a part of a group policies. So we haven't added a group edit policies because we are not a part of a domain. Then there are some policies related to IP security. Then there are some policies related to advanced audit policies. Like you want to audit your system regularly, then you can by going over here. And if I just expand it down, you can see here a system audit policies. And we haven't configured anything, account logon, DS access, then privilege use system, and so on. So this was the short overview of this security policy editor, that what else we can do. So what else we can do is, even if you want to import a security policy and if you want to export a security policies, then just for example, this is one operating system. So you have configured this operating system. By going here to the local security policies, you have made the system secure. Now what you can do is, you can import or export this security policies, same security policies on your desktop. Then you can just copy that file and you can paste it on another computer. Then you have to do is, you just have to open this local security policy editor and then you can import that policies same in that computer. So just go here to the action and here you can see export settings. So if I click over here, so we can export these same policy settings to any file, like let me save here to the demo and click on save. So you will see here that a file, CSV file, is created. Now if you just want to apply the same security policy settings in another computer, then what you have to do is, you just have to open this local security policy editor in that computer. Then you have to go here to the action and then click on import settings, and then you have to give a link of that particular file, and you can see here settings successfully imported. So this is how we can implement security policies. Now last but not the least, there is one product of Microsoft called as Microsoft Security Baseline Analyzer. So you can see here, so this product is actually maintained by Microsoft. So what this product will do, this product is actually used for scanning and auditing the security vulnerabilities in a particular system. So you can download this product from here, from their official website, and the latest version of this product is 2.3. So if you are a system administrator or if you are a network administrator, what you can do, you can just download this product in order to scan the security updates, security vulnerabilities in your system. So here you can see that I have already installed Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer, and while installing this product, you have to fulfill some dependencies issues. So click on yes, and here you can see that this is how the Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer looks like. So there are three features of this tool. The first one is, it can scan a computer by using its name or IP address. And the second one is that we can even scan multiple computers by using this product, Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. And we can even see the existing reports or our previously scanned reports. So let me just go here to the scan a computer. So here you can see that it has automatically detected my computer name and it's saying this computer. So we can even scan a computer by writing its IP address also. And here you can check and uncheck some options depending upon your need. So let's just click on start scan. First of all, it will download some security update information. Then it will match your security information, system information to its downloaded security update information. Then in the last, it will make a report. And here you can see that it has made a report for us. So report detail for the work group and its my system name. So computer name here you can see along with IP address and scan date and scan with MBSA version, that is Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. And if I scroll down here, you can see that it's giving me the score. So the issue is developer tools runtime security updates, that one security update is missing that I have to update it. Then again the offline security update, again 18 security updates are missing. Then SQL Server security updates, okay, it's updated. And if I scroll down here, you can see that it's showing us the Windows administrative vulnerabilities. See, the password expiration means all user accounts have non-expiring passwords, which means I haven't added any kind of security policy rule here to expire a password after a certain period of time. So in order to resolve this issue, what we can do, we can just go to security policy editor and we can implement that security rule that after a particular time our password will expire. So similarly, here you can see no incomplete software update installation found, Windows Firewall. So Windows Firewall is enabled and has exception configured, which means we have to enable network connection and we also have to set some inbound outbound rules. And here you can see that the internet scan result along with the SQL Server scan results, and at the bottom you can see here the desktop application scan results. So this is how we can scan our system by using Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer. And let me just go back here. So here is one option, scan multiple computers. So let me click over here, and here you can see that first of all we have to add a domain name here. So that domain will actually a part of, so that domain contains all computers. So then what we have to do is, so we have to specify IP address range. So here you have to add the starting IP and here you have to add the ending IP. So even you can add here broadcast IP also. So just click on scan, start scan, then it will start scanning all the computers which are present in that domain, and in the last it will make a report for you. So we can even see the existing reports by clicking over here, view existing reports. So right now I have scanned my system 3 times. So you can see here 3 reports along with the date and time. So this is how Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer works. So in this video we have covered that how we can encrypt passwords of SAM database and how we can configure security policies in our system and how we can use Microsoft Baseline Security Analyzer in order to secure our system. So thanks for watching this video.